What's up, beautiful people? In this video, we will be trying and attempting to kill my slug infestational problem with the use of some beer. Okay? Beer traps is what it has resulted to, and the time is now. Let's go. What's up, beautiful people, and welcome to another episode of What's up, beautiful people? It's your boy Ricky Jones Jr. and I am also excited to be with y'all here today. As I am each and every day, I have the opportunity to be before you for yet another video. And in this one, like I said, we will be attempting to do an experiment. This is a 5-day experiment to get rid of, to annihilate, and to destroy this slug problem that I'm having, because the BT did work for the caterpillars. I don't see any more caterpillars on there or anything like that, or any bugs or any little eggs or anything like that. However, I have come across some slugs, okay? And I didn't get any video footage of them because every time I see them, it is dark outside on the way to the gym, and I only have time to get them off with a branch because I'm not touching them with my fingers. And I get them, I flick them, and I've stepped on a couple, okay? I've just been frustrated, that frustrated, okay? I am sorry to say, I have killed the slug. Okay, that was a moment of silence. Nonetheless, here we are again, attempting to find a way to not have them to come back again, okay? And so we're going to use the beer traps, okay? It's a way in which people say it does work. And so we're going to give it a try here. 5 days. Today is Monday. I'm going to film back on Friday, finalize the video, and that'll be what it is. And we'll see the results, okay? And I have a big old can of beer, which I'm not going to post the beer because I have a pretty clean record, and I want to keep it that way. But nonetheless, what I will do is put two different bowls that will have beer in, one on the keyhole raised bed, which is where I'm having a problem, and one on the floor area, okay? And I'll explain why I'm doing the two after I put the two out, okay? So let's go ahead and put them out, and we'll do that part. All right, so the first one I'm going to put over here, which my problem has been taking place just over to the right of it. But nonetheless, I'm just gonna dig on in here so that the slugs don't have, you know, far to get in, because they need to get on in here, okay? So I'm gonna make sure it's nice and tight, making sure no dirt or anything can get in there. All right, there we go. All right, so this is your good old beer trap for the beer trap. All right, I think I'm pretty solid now. I really don't know how much beer to put. I think that's enough, because once they go in, I just want them to drown. Whew, you can smell that beer
a mile away.
All right, and so the other area I'm gonna put it out here is in between my two raised beds. I have my keyhole raised bed over there, and then my regular raised bed right over there, which is a square foot garden, both of them. But nonetheless, I have been seeing some activity on plants on both this side as well as over here, my kale to be more specifically, or be more specific. And so what I'm gonna do is, with this bowl here, I'm gonna put some more of the beer with the idea of, come on, slugs, this is what you want. Come drink it up, leave my stuff alone. All right, great people, so for those that are trying to figure out how it all works, well, the system is as follow. You can see the two in the background. The slugs themselves and all those different creepy things, they're attracted to the malt as well as the yeast smell that beer has. And so with that smell, they will be attracted to it, and they will come and feast in it, and then ideally, they'll drown, okay? So it's not like I did it, but they did it to themselves. That's the whole idea. I feel a little bit more humane about it. However, the thing is, this is the little whammy about it, okay? Yes, they will be attracted to it, so ideally you'll get rid of what is already taking place. But what could also happen is that new slugs will be introduced to the garden, okay? So that is a con aspect of this whole method and going about it, but it is something that I want to do, because I do want my kale and my collards to grow nice and strong, and the slugs are what is prohibiting it thus far, okay? I've eradicated the other problems, diseases and things like that, but now they are the pest that is the problem. So I will definitely do a day-by-day tracking of the progress, okay? Tonight will be the first night, Monday night all the way to Thursday night, and we'll do a full assessment on Friday, okay? And that'll be a whole video that we will put all together, okay? So this is day uno. So I'm excited to see what will be floating in this here bath in the morning, okay? All right, people, I'll see you then. Day one. Let's go.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, so night one, we have a nothing in a bowl. This is just some wood chips over here, which this is the one obviously in a raised bed. And there aren't any damages or any slugs or anything on my kale and my collard plant. So we're looking good. Let's go to the other one. Here as well, we have a nothing. These are just some nothing, just some dust, some dirt particles, okay? So night one, zero. All right, here we are day two. There is nothing in the bowl. I must say there isn't anything over on the plants either. So I'm gonna say right now we're successful. Maybe I eradicated the slug problem by hand, but hey, I mean, I would be surprised if I did. It looks like that because it was raining outside, so it's wet. But the kale, dino kale, it's pretty cool. That's why I like growing it too. Anyway, that's not what this is about. Let's go look at the other bowl, which is empty as well. So, hey, this is empty. That looks good. It's growing nice and healthy. So maybe the BT worked or the slugs are gone. I don't know. However, it looks good, especially like the new growth. We can look at the new growth. It's nice and full for the kale. So empty here, not a problem there. It's day two. Day two, ladies and gentlemen. Here we go. I waited a little later today and nothing. And I even came out here last night. There wasn't anything. So maybe I just got rid of them the natural way by catching them and flinging them. As well as nothing here either. Ladies and gentlemen, one more day. Nothing to say, nothing to see. Okay, great people, so we are on day, it was Friday morning, and looks like a little coal over, but I don't see. Let me see, we might have something in here. May have something or someone. Nope, this is all dirt, dust, and debris. So, no, nothing. Let's see about the other one. And the other one, nothing again, ladies and gentlemen. So let's talk about the effects of the beer trap.
All right, great people. So let's talk about what could have taken place or maybe what happened and not really like throw out the whole idea behind the, you know, beer situation, the beer trap for the slugs. Well, do keep in mind that I did recently do the video where I sprayed the BT spray on those particular plants where the problem was taking place. And then the BT spray wasn't working as fast as I wanted it to. Therefore, I went to this potential solution. Now, here's the dilemma. The BT spray isn't something that happens immediately or like rapidly. Right, it takes for these slugs, the caterpillars and things like that to eat the BT spray particles that are left on the leaves themselves, and then they go do their thing and pass away, right? That's how that works. Now, what took place here with the beer, well, what didn't take place with the beer trap was that the idea was that as they are living, they would go into the trap, drown, and obviously transition that way. However, what could have been is that what I did with the BT spray could have taken away or taken care of the problem, and so there wasn't any slugs, any caterpillars that were still going to be in the trap. Also, like I said, I did found two after I sprayed. I discarded them from the garden and make sure they wouldn't come back. Okay, you can fill in the blanks just like that, because I don't know if kids are watching this video, but nonetheless, I did take care of them. So maybe those were the ones that was causing the problems. I don't know. Here are all various possibilities and or situations that could have, you know, misconstrued the facts of the whole beer trap. So with that being said, I don't want to totally debunk the idea that it does work, because I have seen it work for others. So, you know, that's why I gave it a try. But at the end of the day, if you have given this here beer trap situation a try and it's worked for you, let us know in the comment section below. So there will be hope for those who maybe want to give this a try. And maybe based off of this video, they felt like, no, why would I waste my time doing so? I don't want to go buy beer, go set this whole situation up. It didn't work for you, Ricky. I don't think it'll work for me. Well, hey, you never know. It works for others, just didn't work for me. So with that being said, great people, I love you all. I appreciate you all. Happy gardening, happy living, happy eating. Do it the organic way. And remember, if you ever have any dilemmas, problems, or questions, you can always garden with me. I can start you off, okay? So with that being said, until next time, peace. Let's have fun in the garden. Slug free. Yeah.